Effectsverse presents. Da Vinci's lion robot hides a special surprise. Da Vinci had a lion robot? This is going to be cool. Okay, well, before we get into the story, help us spread the word about Factsverse by clicking that like button. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Leonardo da Vinci was considered a genius. He mastered art, engineering, and mathematics. Many objects in Da Vinci's archives were considered cutting-edge designs during the Renaissance, and even today. There are some artisans today who believe they can recreate one of Da Vinci's strangest and most complex machines. Historians associate Da Vinci with Italy because that's where he was born and where he spent most of his professional life. But Italy wasn't the only place he spent time. He created one of his boldest creations in Amboise, France, and there he did more than just paint. Much of Da Vinci's work was centuries ahead of its time. He created a design for a flying machine over 500 years before the airplane was invented. He was on the right track with his designs, too, and the Wright brothers finished his work centuries later. Sketches from the end of Da Vinci's life were found, and one was the design for a mechanical lion. He built a couple of versions of the lion for King Francis I of France. The prototypes were said to be incredible. Today, Da Vinci's home at Chateau Clos Luce is a museum. The museum president, François Saint-Brice, has had a fascination with the lion automatons ever since he saw it. Without electricity, the lions could walk, move their heads and their tails, and Saint-Brice found that to be incredible. In 2009, François had a pretty daring idea. He wondered if it would be possible for him to recreate the lion automaton based on the original blueprints. Over the years, historians and art critics found this one Da Vinci code impossible to solve. The staff at the Clos Luce tracked down a genius craftsman whose intellect could rival Da Vinci's. The museum staff got in touch with a French artist named Renato Boaretto. He was a veteran designer, and he made a name for himself by using old-fashioned technology to create incredible machines. Some of his most lifelike features was a magician who could make a woman levitate, to a musician capable of moving his bow across a cello. When the museum contacted him about the lion, he couldn't resist the offer. He didn't have much to work with, since only fragments of the original blueprints were available, and he would try and fill in the blanks. Over the years, Renato had sculpted many detailed faces, which made the task of making the lion lifelike not all that difficult. He was a bit worried about the design of the machine, though. He knew that based on the dimensions of a real-life lion, he would need to be at least 130 pounds. He also had to make sure that there was enough space inside to keep the delicate gears and pulleys from getting crushed. Also, the blueprints for the mechanics that would make the lion walk were gone forever. This meant that Renato would need to use designs from his own past inventions to make the lion walk. It took Renato months to bring the lion together and make his art and engineering appear lifelike. To get the large automaton to move, the mechanics of it would be powered by a simple key. This was the way Da Vinci was said to have done it, so Renato wanted to do it the same way. He says the only way to truly replicate what Da Vinci had in mind for the lion, he had to do things exactly the same way. On the day of the demonstration, he prayed that the key would work and the lion would begin moving. With one turn of the key, he would find out if his automation would be a success or a colossal failure. After all those months of work, he prayed for success. When Renato turned the key, the lion walked. He could walk about 10 steps at a time without the need for additional power or a track. Da Vinci's lion robot hides a special surprise that was all Renato's idea, too. He wanted the lion to replicate Da Vinci's as much as possible, but wanted to add his own little flair, too. At the end of the lion's walk, a compartment in his side opened that held a bouquet of lilies, which is the national flower of France. Everyone at the museum was thrilled by what Renato pulled off, and they were very impressed. They hoped that the lion was going to work the way that it may have when Da Vinci first created the blueprints. And now the museum has Da Vinci's lion on display, which is pretty amazing. Subscribe for more!